guys, it's your girl Miss Diva back at it again, and as you can see, your girl has been upgraded. Okay, so let me tell you, it's actually funny. Hold on, I'm right here by my closet. So today's video is actually going to be talking about me and my purchase from Zeelool. Okay, now Zeelool is an eyeglass company that you can actually get stylish eyewear glasses. And let me also say, this video is not sponsored, but Zeelool, if you want to sponsor me, hit me up. Okay, yes, so my glasses are from Zeelool, and as I said, they are a place that I'm pretty sure everybody has seen around, that you know, you can get stylish glasses from, you know, you can get prescriptive glasses, you can get sunshades, or if you want to just be a little stylish, you know, have you some glasses on, you can do so, right? So as you guys know, I have been dealing with my old glasses, these old outdated, tore up, not plastic, tape on it, like, y'all, I just been doing myself raggedy, okay? I have not been doing myself justice by continuing dealing with these glasses in the way that they look, okay? Because there's been plenty of times that I've been looking bomb.com, and I haven't been having the right feeling about it because of my eyewear. Now, those that don't really know me like that, that, you know, you might be new to the channel, my name is Ashley, aka Miss Diva, at Lucy Smash, whichever one you want to call me, it's okay. But anytime that I've got dressed and, you know, got my hair together, you know, I put on my little puff, might have did my little wrap around, whatever case may be, my glasses was always the thing that I felt that didn't really give my look a pop, so to speak. You know what I'm saying? And with me, my personality, I love to accentuate my eyes with eyelashes, the eyeliner, eyeshadow. That's mostly what I do. Now, you really won't see me with a lot of lipstick on or like lip shades on, because I'm still trying to learn myself as far as like with the looks that I do, how to accentuate my lips and don't make it look so awkward. You know what I'm saying? So I tend to just put like a little clear lip gloss on and I'm good to go. That's just what I do. But I am wanting to get more into my looks, especially now that I'm doing my glasses, right? So, a little backstory. As you guys know, I have been diagnosed with pseudotumor cerebri. Remember, I talked about that with basically in this video right here, where I talked about being diagnosed with pseudotumor cerebri, which is basically the optic nerve in the back of your eye is swollen. And this happened in February of 2021 when I went to the optometrist to get a new prescriptive glasses. As you can see, the old ones that I was dealing with, and I just wanted to see, has my eyesight changed any, you know, to get a new prescription glasses, because I knew I still had my old job's insurance at the time, you know, still going on. So went there, and she basically told me that the optic nerve in the back of my eye was swollen and that she couldn't give me prescriptive eyewear. Like, she couldn't actually give me a prescription for my glasses, which I thought was weird, because I'm like, well, if I'm paying $45 for this visit, excuse the noise in the background, you guys, if I'm paying $45 for this visit, I believe I at least should have been able to get some kind of prescription, or hell, at least tell me what the prescription is for these glasses, right? She didn't do nothing. All she did was write up the script for an MRI to check, just to make sure that there's no like brain tumors and things and stuff like that going on, but I never went to go get it checked out, simply because of the insurance that I have, right? Remember, you guys, I was talking about Gold Card, Harris Health System in Houston, Texas. Really, if you don't have the money, you're not going to have good insurance. I'm just put it straightforward. And a lot of people can attest to that, right? So, finally, down the line, I was able to schedule an ophthalmologist appointment, which is basically a doctor that studies the disease of the eyes and stuff like that. Like, let's say if someone has diabetes and they can't really see out of their eyes good, or maybe they were blind or something, they are the ones to able to, you know, figure out what's going on and how they can help with the eyesight of the person, versus a general optometrist is the person that would just look at your eyes, check to see, you know, what kind of script you need, and, you know, give you your prescription for your glasses. So I went to an ophthalmologist. So he was looking at the back of my eye, and I didn't really like his disposition because he was very, like, kind of rushy, like, very just like, okay, what you in here for? All right, let me check it. Yeah, you're good. It's just congestion. That's all you need. All right, let's get you checked out. Like, that's literally how it felt to me. And as you guys will see, I will also post that in this video as well, of how my optometry, well, at least I was in the room waiting for the doctor to come in, and I was just kind of giving a pan around the room and stuff like that. So that's what happened that day. And he basically said overall that the back of my optic nerve is congested. So basically like a sinus congestion on the back of my eyes. He said, you know, it could be easily, you know, brought down if I just lost some weight, which is understandable because when I looked it up and Googled it about having pseudotumor cerebri, it said that ways that it can be cured is like weight loss and stuff like that. It's understandable, but of course, me having PCOS and having issues with weight loss is like a whole goddamn, you know, full of everything, you know, say a whole jambalaya of the reason why it could be happening. But basically, overall, he said that there is nothing wrong, that I'm good to go, and I can easily get a new script for my glasses. What I was supposedly diagnosed with was the pseudotumor cerebri does not hinder me from getting my new glasses, which I knew it did. But I just wanted to make sure, right? Because I was having like, I'm still having like, if I laugh too much or laugh too hearty, or let's say I might stretch. You know how sometimes when you stretch, you kind of hold your breath and you're doing like the yawns and, you know, doing all that. I instantly get a rushing headache. And it is very uncomfortable. It is just, oh my God, it's very annoying at the same time, right? So that's why I wanted to get the second opinion. So he basically said that my eyesight is good. Well, he didn't say it. The assistant that actually dilated my eyes and, you know, just to check and see if, take the pictures of my eyes and stuff like that so the doctor can see it. She was the one that was basically saying that my eyesight is very good, that I don't really have that many issues. I do have a lot of astigmatism, which I've been having that since I was younger. And I had glasses, you know, around 10, 11, 12. So, you know, I've been having that issue with astigmatism. But other than that, my eyesight is good enough that I can get my prescription glass. So, this year I actually went and picked up my old prescription from the last place that I got my glasses done, which were these glasses. The script that is in these glasses are in these glasses now. So, I picked up my old prescription. The lady was like, you know, this script is like from 2015, right? I was like, yeah, that's no problem. I just wanted to have it on backup so therefore I could show the new doctor, the optometrist, you know, just to do like a comparison, just to see like, has my eyesight really changed? It hasn't really changed much, maybe like a few numbers up, a few numbers down, but yes, it's pretty much the same script. Your eyes are still doing good, you know. That's why I wanted to get a copy of it. So when I went to the ophthalmologist and how he was kind of rushy, and I'm like, I didn't expect this is how the visit was gonna go. I thought it was gonna be like, you know, you really testing my eyes and, you know, doing like the kind of exam that an optometrist would do, but apparently that's two different fields of testing. So yeah, so saying all that to say, the same script that are in these old glasses are now in these. So these particular Zeelool glasses are prescriptive for me, and let me tell you, I can see clearly now, the rain is gone. I can see all obstacles in my way. Like, for real. If you guys can see, I don't know if you guys can see it, but you see that kind of like scuffiness on the glasses right there? Yeah, can y'all see that? Oh my gosh. This is basically the layer of like the film within the glasses. The film within the glasses is basically starting to peel. I don't know if you guys can see that. Can y'all see that? See how it looks dirty? These glasses are not dirty. I promise you. I promise you. I can clean it right now. Matter of fact, yeah. And this is my eyeglass case, you guys. It is so cute. I bought this on Amazon. Yes. I'm like, yo, I went out. I was like, okay, you know what? I got me some new glasses. I want me a stylish case. Now, the ones on Zeelool, they cute, but I wanted something more popping. And lately, I've been feeling red. Like, I don't know why, but I'm just feeling red. Like, red and black. So, when I seen this, this is actually a sunglasses case. Because, you know, sunglasses can gotta be big and bulky. So, that's kind of like what this is. But because my glasses are more, you know, kind of bigger like that, I was like, this would be perfect. Because I want my glasses to fit. And so, when I seen it, I was like, I'm getting this. This is it right here. This one right here was $8.99, and I will leave it in the description box below just in case you guys want to pick you up one. So it did come with the case, and it also came like with a eyeglass wipe. So, like I said, these glasses are not dirty. I'm about to clean it right now just to show y'all. This film that was on the glasses are so scuffed up. And it's literally like whenever I use like anything that was wet to clean the glasses, like an eyeglass, alcoholic pad, or like the fog wipes for your glasses, over time it's been peeling up and it's been like very scuffy. Even if I was to look into a light, my mom be like, is your glasses clean? I'm like, child, they as clean as can be. But the damn film is just keep peeling up. Like, it don't, it made my eyesight very cloudy and very annoying. So when the first day I got my glasses and I tried them on, y'all, I was gonna get myself together. As y'all can see, I did the little nose piercing. I actually switched it out for it's kind of like a what is it called, kind of like a diamond cube zirconian type, you know, you probably can't see it, but yeah, I switch it out. I really want to go, but you know, oh, I got so many in my car. Y'all just don't understand. But okay. I digress. All right, so I clean the glasses, right? Now, you see how you can still see that little scuffy stuff on there? This is exactly what I was dealing with since, I believe I had these glasses since high school. And I believe, well, I graduated high school in June of 2015. But I've been having these glasses since then, and it's 2023. So yeah, I've been sleeping on myself, for real. But these are my glasses, and I'm gonna take them off just to show what they look like. These are the glasses. And y'all, I mean, talk about cute. What? When I seen it on the picture, the good thing about Zeelool is that they have it to where you can upload your own photo so you can see how it's going to look on your face. So when I originally did the picture for the glasses, I didn't think they were going to look like this. So I thought they were going to be more like squared off, so to speak. Like, let me show you the difference. These are the Zeelool glasses, right? And these are my old glasses. You see the difference? I thought they were going to be more squared off. But you see how I'm looking, how I'm feeling? I know I kind of look like, hold on, let me get myself together. The shirt is kind of rouging up on me. Okay, so let's say I'm going out, right? I'm feeling myself. I'm cute. You know, I got my little puff on. You know, my little protective style wear. Let's say I got the bottoms on, the shoes on, looking good. But my glasses was always just throwing off the look. Like, I needed something more popping. And, you know, I used to try on different glasses. I used to try my mom's glasses because she also bought a pair from Zeelool, too. But yeah, I just always, I mean, I can do so much with my eyes, but my glasses just not popping. So for the longest time, I've been trying to get to the optometrist so I can get a new pair of glasses, but they would just want to play games, right? So one day, like I said, in a nutshell, I took the leap of faith. I ordered my glasses. I was like, you know what? I'm going to do it. These are the ones I got. And when I tell y'all I can see clear out these glasses, another thing that I love about these glasses is that it does not have that glare. Like, whenever you look into the light, because I do have a ring light right here, you can see it that way. But if I was to take pictures or anything, it's not going to have that flash within my glasses. And that's one thing that I really, really, really love about these glasses, is that you can pick certain options. I don't have mine to where it goes, like, that transition within the sunlight. I just wanted to get one pair that was regular. Excuse me, y'all. I just wanted to get one pair that was regular for the meantime, between time, so I could test it to see, you know, was the prescription going to be perfectly in alignment, so therefore I could wear the glasses, right? I have no qualms. Okay, so I will leave the name right here of what the glasses are called. I will definitely put it in the description box below. Let's see. Within my box of my Zeelool package, they did give me a $7 off coupon, which I will be using that on my next order, because I'm about to be ordering me some glasses, okay? Yes, ma'am. So when it did come in, it came within a Zeelool little baggie. It came also with the Zeelool eyeglass wipe, so therefore you can keep your glasses clean. And it also came with a PD ruler. The PD ruler, I forgot what it stands for, but I'll definitely insert it within the video. It's basically to measure where your pupils are, so therefore they can align them right into where your pupils align within your glasses when you see, right? Because at first I kept seeing like PD ruler, what is that? I don't have that. So it's actually an app, and I will insert it right here in the video as well, that you can use if you don't necessarily have a PD ruler, or if you can't necessarily get to an optometrist to measure your PD. You can just do it on the app, and I did mine like 15 times. I just wanted to make sure that I was getting the same number. And once I got the same number three times or more, I was like, okay, that's the number I should go for, right? So basically, you'll do it like this, and it measures where your pupil is aligned, so that therefore, let's say if you're wearing your glasses, your pupil is going to be aligned straight where your lens should be. So therefore, you know, when you put your prescription in, if you have a prescription that you need for your glasses, it'll be aligned. So therefore you can see. So mine was 65, and for my PD, and like I said, this is prescriptive glasses, I could see clearly out of them. I mean, I wanted to cry when I first got my glasses, because y'all don't understand this scuffiness. I mean, how you gonna be cute and you got tape on the side of your glasses? Like, damn. I remember the day that I woke up and I was like, why my glasses like keep falling off? The whole damn little thing just fell off one day. I had to tape it up. I had to change the little paddings within my glasses. Like, y'all, 2015 to 2023, that don't make no sense. Like, I've just been sleeping on myself, okay? But I tell you one thing, not no more. Zeelool is where it's at, okay? So make sure you guys check out Zeelool. I will make sure to leave all the links in the description box below. In a video that you will see next after this, I'll be showing my initial review of me going to the ophthalmologist. And basically showing you how I first looked when I first took the glasses out of the box, okay? So I wanted to give like a little look, you know, give a little face, so to speak, on how I'm looking now with the glasses. So therefore, I can also see myself. Like, girl, you finna be styling and profiling when you leave the house. Yes, ma'am. We about to do it. So y'all, definitely stay tuned for some more Zeelool reviews, because I'm about to have a whole box. I mean, I've been shopping on Amazon for like the box that you can put all your glasses in. Like, what? I'm about to have shades. I'm about to do it all. Okay? I'm telling you. I've been sleeping on myself. I've been feeling so bad sometimes when I be going out the house, because I'm like, ugh, I done got my nose pierced now. Like, man, I really want to spice up my look. And that's also why, I know I was supposed to end the video, but I'm just say what I'm about to say before I end it, right? That is also why I did the nose piercing, because it was random. I know I said in the video it wasn't random. It was definitely random. My mama sent me something. I think it was an item on probably Temu. I believe it was Temu. And I'm pretty sure you guys have been seeing Temu ads everywhere. I mean, it's on every YouTube video you might click on. You might be on Instagram. Somehow, some way, you know about Temu, right? I have purchased a few things from there, and they actually are legit. So, I'm not mad. But I think she sent me something about a nose piercing from home. Like, you know, like a little kit. And I was like, it's kind of interesting. Nose piercing. Like, I always thought about getting my nose pierced. But I was like, I don't know. Like, how is it going to look? Because, you know, I got a distinctive nose, right? And certain glasses that I do wear wouldn't necessarily fit my face because of the roundness of my face, for one, and the shape of my nose. You know what I'm saying? So I don't want to be looking like, what's them glasses that's kind of like a, you know what I'm talking about, with the little nose, like stuff that they used to have as like party favors back in the day. I don't want to be looking like that. You know, I want to be looking cute and stylish and profiling with mine. I want to look like Miss Diva, okay? And so, she sent me that, and I was like, you know what, I want to try it. So I was looking up a whole bunch of videos on how to do the nose piercing at home. A lot of people were saying that it was very quick and easy, you know. It didn't really hurt as bad as they thought it would. So I was scared, because I was like, am I really going to do all that? Because I want to get a tattoo, but I'm like, I don't know, like, you know. So what I bought from Amazon, it was a 2-pack. And it basically looks like this. So as you can see, that little, let me see if it'll focus. You see that little needle right there? That is basically what the little, it's basically like a contraption. So if you ever seen it on, if you ever seen it, or if you ever went to get your ears pierced, it's basically, you know how when they do the earpieces, it's like a little gun that they will press, you know, to pierce the ears. So this is basically a disposable, let's see if it's gonna focus. Focus. It's a disposable nose piercing unit. Now this set that I had purchased, it came with two in a pack. So I already used one, and I only plan to use one. I don't wanna pierce all of this. Okay, so yes, I thought this was pretty cool. I ordered from Amazon. It came with a 2-pack, and I'll also leave it in the description box below if you guys want to get you one. Excuse me. It was very simple. Painful, I would say, for about 5 seconds. When you putting it on the place that you want to put it at, and you are pressing it yourself, you're going to feel that little needle trying to stick through your nose. Okay. Whew, child. Once you get it there, you better just hurry up and push it and get it over with. Because you ain't going to want to try to do it again if you take it out and get scared. Like, oh my God, no, wait, I don't want to do it. Either have somebody that's going to hit it for you, or just hurry up and do it. Just take you a shot or something. If you don't drink, find you something that you can just try to grab onto. Bite a towel or something if you want to just do it, you know. But me, I was a straight shooter. I just like, like, you know what I'm saying? I did it. I was like, fuck. And as you guys will see, check out that video where I actually pierced my nose and I had my mom's reaction. So yeah, I did it. So this is what it looks like. It has healed very good. One thing that I can say, and I will also insert pictures of that as well within this video, depending on where you pierce your nose, is the diameter of the size of the ring or piercing that you want to get. So like if you have a ring within your nose, it's a certain diameter that you would pick with, let's say this is a circle, right? The diameter basically is the width of the inside of the piercing, you know, circle. Depends on where you put your piercing at is the width that you would need. So therefore, it can go within the nose of the hole and then, you know, be able to clamp. Or let's say if it's one that doesn't clamp, but, you know, it's still open. You need to make sure that you pick the right size, because if you don't, like I did accidentally, the gold nose ring that you see in this video right here was actually cutting me on the underneath of my, like, my little nose part right here, and I didn't know it. I kept, like, sometimes I would move my nose, and I'm like, ow, like, but I thought it was the hole itself, because, like, within a week or so, I was able to change out my, my nose ring, so I thought it was just, you know, the hole itself, but no, it was actually, the ring was actually, like, cutting me underneath my damn nose. Didn't even know about it. So I put some tea tree oil and Vaseline. It's like a mixture that I did, that me and my mom has been doing for years now, and it healed up pretty good. So I'm being very mindful of the nose rings that I get from now on. But yeah, I have plenty in my cart that I want to do. That's also why, in a nutshell, why I did the piercing for my nose, because I knew that I wanted to get my face more pop. Like, I'm already doing it with the eyes, I'm doing it with the glasses now, so it's like I need something else to just make it pop, right? So yeah, that's what I did. And my nose is pierced, I got my new glasses, and yes ma'am, your girl looking good, okay? So yes, you guys stay tuned, as I said, because I'm going to be doing more Zeelool reviews on glasses. And yeah, I will see you guys next time. Bye. Oh,